So students, let's start with a new problem where a simply supported beam is given and over the beam there is a complex force system, and in this force system there is a UDL of 20 kN per meter of intensity is given over a length of 6 meter, and there is a point load which is 40 kN given at D point. Now let's start with learning how we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram for this complex force system. Now there, first of all, we need to find out the support reaction, which is RA and RB, which we can find out by taking equilibrium equation, which is summation Fi0 and summation M0. So when we apply summation Fi0, so we'll get what? RA plus RB is equal to total load, which is UDL, and point load. So total load by UDL is 20 into 6, which is 120, plus 40 kN, which is point load. So total load will be 160. So we'll get equation RA plus RB is equal to 160 kN. Thereafter, we'll take moment about B. So let's take moment about B. So when we'll take moment about B, so starting from left end, so there is first RA. So the moment of RA about B will be RA into 12. And then we'll have to take the moment of this UDL, which you already know. How we'll take the UDL moment, which is 20 into 6, which is the total load by the UDL, multiply by, now this total UDL will act at the center point of 6 meter. Now the distance of this total load UDL will from the B will be 3 plus 3 plus 3. So it will be 9, total 9. So the moment of the UDL will be 20 into 6 into 9. And then moment of this 40 kN, which will be minus 40 into 3. So this is how we can find out the reaction RA and RB. So by this process, we will get reaction RA and RB, which is 100 kN and 16 kN. Now let's start with making shear force diagram. So in the shear force diagram, what we'll do, we'll have to start with the left end, which is RA. So RA is given 100 kN. So what we'll do from point A, so we'll do what? We'll move by 100 kN distance from A. Now after that, next point is C point. So we can see from A to C, there is a UDL of 20 into 6, which is total 120 kN, and we need to go downside. Now, I told you in the last lecture that whenever there is UDL, so always in the shear force diagram, there will be a slope line. So total, we need to move down by 120. So here it is 100. So when we'll reach to the C, so it will be 100 minus 120. So we'll reach to the minus 20 over here. So what we'll do? We will join this by a slope line. So there, when we'll reach to the C point, so we'll have minus 20 kN. Now let's move ahead. Now after that, there is a point C. So after reaching to the point C, we can see between C and D, there is no load. So if there is no load, then important point number one is what? When there is no load, so shear force diagram always move parallel to the beam axis. And the beam axis is this one. Now after that, there is a point load at point D. So whenever there is point D, so important point number two. So always you have to move to the in the direction of point load. So there is one minus 20, and then again we need to move downside by minus 40. So minus 20 and minus 40 will get minus 60. Now we can see between D and B, there is no point load or there is no load. So what we'll do? Again, we'll go straight parallel to the beam axis. So there we'll have, so this is incorrect. There will be minus 60. Now what we'll do? Now RB is upward with 60 kN. So we need to move upward by 60 kN, and there finally you will get 0. So this is how we can draw shear force diagram for a complex system. Now let's start how to make bending moment diagram. So in the bending moment diagram, so first of all we need to find out what bending moment at each and every point. So we have how many points? 4 points: A point, C point, D point, and B point. So on all these 4 points, we need to find out the bending moment. Thereafter, one more point we get here in shear force diagram, where shear force has changed its sign from positive to negative. So that is this point. So before starting that, we need to find out this point where shear force has changed its sign. So how we can find out? So we assume, let this is x. So this will be 6 minus x. So we'll take the ratio of corresponding side of these two similar triangles. So how we can find out that? We'll take x upon, which is this one, 100, and then that is equal to 6 minus x upon, which is 20. So by this equation we'll get the value of x, whatever it will come. So this is how we can find out the x location, location of the point where bending moment will come maximum. So now start finding out the bending moment equation. So first at point A, so we'll get bending moment is equal to 0 because there is no force on the left side of A. And next is, let's find out bending moment at C. So when we'll have bending moment at C, so there will become an equation, and that equation will be equal to, so bending moment at C will be equal to what? So this is C point. So we'll have to take the moment, algebraic sum of moment on the leftward forces. So leftward force, there are RA and UDL. So we'll get some value over here, and that value is 240 kN. And I hope you know how to find out bending moment at C. I can show you here, which will be plus RA multiply by 6, then minus, now the total UDL load is 20 into 6 into 6 by 2. This is the bending moment equation to find out bending moment at C. Now thereafter, so we'll get the bending moment value at C is 240. Thereafter, we need to find out bending moment at D. So when we'll have bending moment at D, again I can write out the equation to find out bending moment at D, which will be plus RA into, now the total distance of RA from D is 9. So we'll get 9, then minus, now the total load of UDL is 20 into 6. Now this is the total load. Multiply by distance of the total UDL from D. So total UDL will act at center of the 6. So it will be 3 plus 3. So you can check in the equation. So this will be bending moment at D. Next we need to find out bending moment at B. So you can find out which you have earlier find out in while finding out the reaction. In this equation you have taken already bending moment at B. So which will come 0. Now after that, what we need to do? Here we got the bending moment value at A, bending moment at C, bending moment at D, and as well as bending moment at B. Now next is to find out bending moment maximum. So maximum bending moment is at the point where shear force changes its sign. So that is this one. Now we can see this point is in between C. So what we can do? We can take a section at a distance of X. And we need to find out bending moment equation on this action, on this section, sorry, XX. Now when we'll get bending moment equation on this section XX, so what will, in terms of X, so what we'll do? So we earlier get X where bending moment will be maximum. So we'll put that X value in the equation and then we'll get a maximum bending moment. Now the bending moment equation at section XX, which is at a distance of X, will be what? So let's find out. MX will be equal to plus RA into X minus 20 into X, which is the total UDL on the left side of the section, and multiply by X by 2, because at a distance of X UDL is acting, so the moment of that UDL on the left side section is X by 2. So we'll have to multiply by X by 2. So this will be the bending moment equation on section XX. Now in this equation we have to put the value of X where shear force was coming 0. So when we put X value over here, so we'll get M maximum. So after getting M maximum, now we got all the points. So one is this point at here. Here the value is 0. So here we'll mark certain value over there. So which you get the maximum bending moment. This point we already have the value. This point already we have the value. And there again we found it is 0. Now we have all these points. Now the question comes, how we need to draw the bending moment diagram. So I already mentioned in the previous lectures that wherever there is UDL, so bending moment diagram will be always curve. So join all the points which comes under UDL by parabolic line. Thereafter between C and D there is no load, so it is straight line. Again between D and B there is no load, so again we have to join by the straight line. So this is how you can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram for a complex force system. Nothing we need to do, we need to just follow the concept, basic concept over there, and then finally we'll get our required diagram for shear force and bending moment as well as. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoyed the lecture. Thank you.